intense focus, carefully examining the design at hand, using all his strength to curve the iron rod, day in, day out. When asked why Zhen Wencheng's hands held on to the iron rods for 30 years, he said giving up was easy. He persisted because he wanted to incessantly exceed himself, of relentlessly pursuing for excellence to fully manifest in his work. This is his life's ambition. Iron-made products are everywhere in our lives. Iron sheds, wrought iron window grills, ironing railing, and even as public landscape display. Zhen's work pieces are displayed all over Taiwan, whether it's in schools and in commissioned projects. From the moment a commissioned design is accepted, the sound of wrought on every iron piece will be heard around the clock from the iron workshop.
通常我收到业主的委托的时候，有可能就它是一张照片设计图，或者是一个3D图，所以委托重新画过。然后我把图面制作好之后，这时候我就会把它的图面拿下来跟徒弟们他们讨论。比如一只手，我不会要求徒弟他们一起成型，因为虽然速度快，可是要做出来不够生动，所以我们会一只手指头这样堆叠，那看起来更像一只手。
Through his vast understanding of the iron bar's malleability, Zhen curves, spot welds, polishes, and assembles. He does them again and again. And through these repeated processes, his creation is visually more three-dimensional and realistic.
我们又接到一个非常有挑战性的一个案子，石门那个茶山步道的六福铁花窗。那当然，它里面的很多错综复杂的线条，而且是密密麻麻的。这时候，我们就思考说，我们自己在做一些字句，包括一些扭折的方式。In
order to minimize the flaw on the black iron after the anti-rust coating, Zhen added four different sizes of stainless steel bars. However, he faced the challenge of handling them. Both the stainless steel and black iron bars are extremely stiff. But the black iron is more flexible than the stainless steel. So when curving the stainless steel bars, the difficulty greatly increased.
不锈钢它的硬度非常高，当你压下180度的时候，它可能会再回弹，就可能剩下170度，没办法到位。 那这时候它就会产生一个非常高的难度。其实这石门铁花窗遇到最大挫折，最让我们意想不到的，它居然是它的外框。那外框一般，我们工厂所有成员都会觉得说外框反而是最好做的，所以我们放到最后面再做。可是当我们在制作的时候，才发现说，原来设计师那个四个角的外框其实每个尺寸是不一样的，而且它的那个弧度啊非常的小。 就委托那个弯管厂看能不能照图样去弯出来，可是弯管厂给的答案就是说，它没办法每个都非常的精准，而且它弯出来的管子其实是会凹陷的。那时候他给我这个答案的时候，我是没办法接受的。In
order to overcome the problem of the denting, Zhen put in threefold the time and disregarded the cost. Finally, he decided to draw the design himself using laser to cut the stainless steel sheets, then welded them together. That finally solved the problem of the denting.
徒弟们还有我都很开心，最起码我们的作品是这方面的缺陷是没有的，而且它是非常完整的。别的同行看到说可能会疑惑，他这怎么弯得出来？他们怎么可以做得到？这就是我们所坚持的地方。After
assembling, the iron parts were sent out for coating.
I've known him for 10 years, and he is very humble. His attitude and behavior sometimes look like his parents. He is not willing to sacrifice anything, but he wants to do the best he can. Taiwan has always been a tradition of cutting edges. I and my Taiwan老师, our goal is to 让这个产业不要只是销价竞争。所以我们尽可能，我们两个的理念是一致的，就是把物件做好。我们不管要花多少时间跟成本，我们就是只想把物件做好，然后做出我们要的标准，是我们自己心里觉得舒服。那当我们觉得舒服，我们把每一个物件都看待，这个会装在我家。如果装在我家里，我花了这些钱来做制作这个东西，我希望它有多好，我们就做到多好。
Wrought iron window grills' popularity was at its height from the 1950s to the 1970s. Each piece of the wrought iron window grill was a piece of art hanging outside the window of each home. However, Jen was in the era where wrought iron window grills were being dismantled and taken down. He seemed to be the executioner whom was taking down and erasing everyone's memory of home mercilessly.
我们又接到一个非常特别的案子，就是云林十三福铁花庄。那云林十三福铁花庄其实是一个艺术家，他所画的，他用手绘的。他因为他有去做田野调查，然后用每家每户的故事去做成的铁花庄。所以那时候他将这个想法跟我讲的时候，我是听到的时候我是非常开心的，因为怎么有铁窗可以去诉说每户每家的这种故事。
啊，盐酸就是迄种，
哎，
啊，所以爸爸迄种做工课，迄个画面伫你，你很脑海中，所以一定无都放袂进。
所以对我来讲，它除了是一个挑战之外，如果可以完成的话，它将一定是一个非常可以感动人的一个作品。
The 13 wrought iron window grills made Jen famous. More and more people wanted to commission him to create wrought iron window grills.To transform the wrought iron window grill into a craft work. Jen broke through traditional old methods in thinning, sharpening, twisting iron bars, and also incorporating his own ideas to allow the iron bars to become more diverse.
在做这些过程的时候，其实我是不计成本去做，用自己最极致的工法，自己认为最好的那种方式去进行的时候，每个环节我都觉得有达到位的时候，对我而言它就是艺术，这也是我最想去追求的。所以当我看到这些成品，我这样用心对待的时候，旁边的人，包括业主或者是路过的人，他们就说：“哇，这个东西很棒，很漂亮。”这时候我得到的不只是成就感，而且这对自己是一种肯定。
Installation is the final step of the work, which means the completion of the commission. Most people regard iron as very stiff, but through the hands of Jen Wencheng, it becomes complex, three-dimensional, lively, and vivid lines, depicting iron in strength and delicateness.The vast experiences he accumulated over time has allowed him to carry the craft of wrought iron window grills to its best, and also unceasingly exceeding himself.
We can see from the online platform some foreign people's work. This is the best of the best. For me, they are the best of the world. What can we do to do this? For me, I think this is the goal of my goal. I hope that I can achieve the best of the world. It sounds very arrogant, but.这个就是我的目标。
Persistence is a high wall hangs in Jen Wencheng's workshop. Whether it is his attitude with his work or his life, this is his guidepost. Some people strive to make their dreams come true. Some people strive to continue their family businesses. The apprentices in the workshop come from all over Taiwan. In the eyes of the apprentices,Jen Wencheng is a teacher who is difficult to get along with because of his persistence, meticulousness, and insistence on excellence.
我觉得老师带给我的影响还蛮深的。我觉得他很有那种实验家的精神嘛，就是他会很去尝试很多不同的方法，或者是去做很多一般人不愿意去做的事情。
The confident second-generation ironworker encountered a lot of frustration when he came to Jen Wencheng's workshop. There were many conflicts in their standpoints. Eventually, his long-standing arrogance was crushed.
我之前可能就是比较粗鲁的去磨我们的铁件，对，因为我觉得那个不是什么，那个只是铁而已。但是在老板这边，他的铁件就是有生命的，所以就是那种观念上的让我冲击很大。我也是慢慢看到老板这样子，我后面也变成是觉得说，哎，他是有生命的那种态度去对待我的东西。
As for passing on the craft, Jen Wencheng taught everyone unreservedly. The craftsman spirit is suffused into the apprentices bit by bit.
要成为匠的时候，就是你要在你的工艺上的时候，你要不断的去追求那种极致的水准，就是他求好，追求完美。你要达到这种境界的时候，那才成为匠，就是你什么事情都办到最好。那我们可不可以做到这件事？我会这样问自己。那你要成为工还是匠？那对我而言，我当然要成为匠。
我时刻提醒自己，只要人们有需要铁的地方，铁匠手中的火就会燃烧。我的力量会让铁千变万化，并且只要用心，就能让赋予新生命的铁展现光芒。我相信，坚持做好一件事，别人自然会看见你手中的光芒。